Your Chamber on BCTV is supported by Herbine & Company, Incorporated.
Hello, this is Mark Dolinski. I'm the Director of Business Services for the Greater Reading Chamber of Commerce, and I'm really pleased to be here today with Adrean Turner, one of our instructors at the Chamber. And our topic today will be on workforce development. And workforce development is really important for not only the business community, but the greater community within Reading and Berks County. And the reason why is by developing a robust workforce development initiative, we are able to supply employers with the skilled labor and employees that they need in order to be vibrant. So today what we'd like to talk to you about is some of the initiatives that the Chamber has. And in Berks County, we are very fortunate to have not only schools that are really taking the workforce development of our young leaders, you know, as something that's very critical, but we have technical institutions that are very important in developing the skill sets of the workforce coming in. And what the Chamber does is we focus on interpersonal skill development because we think this is very critical for a robust and vibrant business community. So what I'd like to do is talk to you today about the global perspective and what we're trying to accomplish. At the Chamber, we have interpersonal skill development. And what does that really mean? That means that we're providing the workers, the supervisors, and managers with the skill sets they need in order to optimize the workforce. And that's why we have Adrean here with us today, because she's one of our instructors, and she's going to provide a little bit more concrete examples as to what we do in our training. So Adrean, I'll turn it over to you.
All right, thank you. One of the things that we wanted to share with you is the effect that having individuals that have great interpersonal skills in your organization can have on your profitability. And one of the things that we've learned from a recent 2014 Gallup poll is that 70% of individuals are disengaged in the workplace. That means they're not emotionally connected. And that is costing American businesses more than $450 billion with a B, $1 billion. And what's the result of that? We have turnover. We have people calling out, so we have higher absenteeism. You have individuals just performing very poorly. And to support individuals, which for organizations, I call them your MVAs, your most valuable assets. It's so vitally critical to provide them with the skill sets, such as what the Chamber offers, so that they can perform at optimal level, so that organizations can reach their greatest productivity and potential.
That's a great point. And when you realize today that we're in a global environment, and our competition isn't just within the local community, the state, or even the nation, it's throughout the world. So that's very important to have engaged, highly skilled workers. And training has been really found to be one of the linchpins of creating an engaged workforce. And as Adrean said, the retention is so vital in keeping the cost down within an organization. So why is that? If you view training as an investment, you'll retain your best employees,
yes,
lower your costs by not having to hire, and you'll maintain the institutional knowledge. So that's very important. So Adrean, do you have any other items you want to discuss as far as the global competition might be concerned?
Well, certainly we know that we're in an economy where we're not just selling to our neighbors, you know, we're in Pennsylvania, so we're not just selling to people in New Jersey and New York. We mm-hmm. are selling, you can sell from Berks County to Bangladesh.
Right.
And because of technology, the internet, you can have access to services from any organization anywhere around the world. So it's critically important that organizations not only have the technology, but you have to have a workforce that is able mm-hmm. to communicate and serve a global customer. And one of the ways that I learned firsthand about this is when I was working in Big Pharma, mm-hmm. and we moved to a global model. And that meant that our organization had to make some important structural changes, and they all centered around the MVAs, mm-hmm. the employees. So we had to get training in managing organizational change. We also needed to understand our customers better so that we could serve them. So there's a lot of different facets when we talk about global competition mm-hmm. and how we can empower mm-hmm. our workforce to serve our customers.
That's really important. Back in the 1980s, Michael Porter, a professor at Harvard, made a really salient book and comment in that it's your competitive edge. And how do you create that competitive edge? And one way is through being highly skilled and highly engaged employees. So that's a great point, Adrean. And one of the missions for the Greater Reading Chamber of Commerce is to provide our employers with the training that they need to increase the skill levels of all their employees. So we have multiple programs, from lead worker programs, supervisor to mid-level management, and actually to the executive level. So what we try to do is create alignment within organizations so that everyone can speak from the same language and understand what the strategy is within those organizations. So the first one I'd like to talk to you about today is our lead worker program. And this is a program that's designed for those employees who are ready to take the next step. They've shown the initiative, they want to take on more accountability, more responsibility, and maybe even step into the role of a supervisor. And what this program is, it's 12 two-hour sessions that we bring in the employees from all kinds of organizations to really develop those skills that are critical, be it communication, be it improving their work habits, dealing with generational differences. And Adrean is one of our instructors here, and I'd like you to maybe elaborate a little bit more on this program.
Certainly. One of the benefits of the Lead Worker Program is that it really provides individuals with opportunities to role play scenarios, to work with colleagues at their same level and gain some understanding about maybe some of the challenges they're having, and to be able to share. But another thing that I like to share is that it's really important for your employees to understand, how do I manage, you know, the conflict that I might be having with a coworker? It's very important for them to understand, how do I de-escalate a customer complaint? How can I help my coworkers be more productive? And what things that can I do to feel trusted and empowered? And these lead worker mm-hmm. courses provide them with those skill sets, with the opportunity to practice. And they also have an opportunity to really ask questions mm-hmm. That are particular to them and their organization. And what I found in working with teams through this training is that they are highly engaged, and that mm-hmm. makes it a wonderful experience for everyone. I also have found that they are, you know, really eager to, I want to say it this way, they're really eager to share the specifics about what they're going through, because they recognize the value and the importance that it could have on them. And that's really important, because when people come into the training, sometimes they don't know what to expect. Mm-hmm. And so when we get that level of engagement, when they can experience learning in a way with their peers that helps them to not only gain these skills, but then go right back into the workplace the next day and implement them. And we find that when they come back for their subsequent sessions, they're sharing stories about, I tried that skill set of listening more to what my boss was saying when I was taking the communication ups course. And this is what I've learned. And so I'm really excited about this, the courses that the chambers offer. I'm going to go back just a little bit and share, you know, I have a love for this, and I really appreciate the work that the chamber is doing, because I was in corporate for over 20 years. I did not have a mentor. And although we had a lot of great training, our training was more around our jobs. It wasn't so much around these interpersonal skills. How do you improve your work habits? Well, work habits is different from your work performance. Your work performance is about your task. But your work habits are like, are you absent from work? Are you very punctual? Do you talk more on the cell phone when you should be back from break time? And so these supervisors and these lead workers learn how to address those concerns, which can be very personal and very, you know, difficult for them to manage on their own. So they leave empowered, and we're really happy to learn about the success that individuals are having.
That's a great point. Just seeing how they, a lot of these individuals haven't been in any kind of a classroom environment for a number of years.
Yes.
So when you see them come back in, you see how invigorated they are, and that they're applying these new skills and it's working. It's really fabulous.
It really is. And it also gives us material to share with the next class.
Absolutely. And then once the employees are able to graduate from our lead worker program, they can move on to our Supervisor Academy. And we're really excited about this, because all the curriculum has just been updated. And what we have done with this is created three separate modules that really addresses those skills that employees have told us are important. So those skills can range from problem solving and decision making. It can range from team building, understanding groups, and how best to delegate. All different kinds of skills that will make them more productive once they get back into the workforce. A lot of times what we like to think about a supervisor is they're like the meat inside of a hamburger.
Oh.
You know, they have to be able to communicate and delegate both down and to their managers. So we have a really robust and engaged sessions. And one thing that you touched on, Adrean, I want to go back on, all our courses are interactive. And that's why it's so important for us not only to develop the leading edge curriculum, but to have the best facilitators. And I just want to maybe throw that over to you, Adrean, and talk a little bit more about what is your mindset and how you approach your philosophy in class, so to speak.
Okay. Well, I will say this. I have a inherent passion for what I do. I love to teach, and I love to read, and so I like to share. But I also gain so much back from that experience. And what my philosophy is with teaching is the same as it is with coaching. You enable individuals through a set of questions by giving them information so that they are able to come up with some answers on their own. When people are involved in the process of learning, it sticks. And so the approach that I take is to enable individuals to truly really understand the curriculum, and then to provide their own examples, and then we talk about solutions. It's almost like a strategic approach, and we come up with recommendations and thoughts together about how they can move forward. And the training that the chamber has is laid out in that manner. mm-hmm. where individuals are able to really be successful in gaining, and I keep saying this, right. but it's gaining and retaining the information and then implementing it right away in the workplace.
That's so important, because this isn't a theoretical experiment. It's how we can really make the employees much more effective once they get back. The other thing I like to touch on is the peer-to-peer learning, because when I go in and I observe these classes, what always fascinates me is how not only are they learning from our curriculum, but mm-hmm. how you set the environment to really maximize the peer-to-peer learning experience.
Yes. With the Supervisor Academy, we had many different exercises. And one of the exercises we did was actually talking about how you can help your employees to learn. Because there's three different ways that employees learn. They learn by seeing, they learn by doing, and they learn by hearing. So first, the individuals had to figure out which way they learned, and then think about specific employees. And the importance of that lesson was so that they see their perspective, because sometimes we have these difficulties or challenges in managing individuals because we're seeing things differently. So it's we enable them to not only learn about their different styles, but how their styles affect their employees, and then what is the style of your employee, and how mm-hmm. can you adapt, and how can you use the way that you manage to influence. And we do specific exercises so that they go through those scenarios, and then we often have someone to say, you know what, I tried that, it did or didn't work, mm-hmm. and they share that experience, and it creates an engagement throughout the entire class where everyone is sharing, and that enhances the overall experience.
Absolutely. And just expanding upon what you said, we have assessments that the participants take so they can find out what kind of profile they have, what kind of individual, are they more cautious, are they an influencer, are they more dominant? And then we move on to the emotional intelligence, because it's so important to have that self-awareness aspect. So when you're a supervisor or a leader within an organization, you really need to understand how others are perceiving your message. Mm-hmm. And I think that's one thing that we try to weave throughout all of our training. So I guess I just want to throw the ball back to you, Adrean, is how can that help the supervisor, say a new supervisor or an experienced supervisor, by having a better understanding of their own awareness of what kind of person they are?
Okay, so I'll share a couple things. First, I want to say, and I'm going back to the information about your work habits and your job performance. Your job performance is task-oriented, but your work habits are personal. They're related to you. And they have a great influence over your work performance, your work mm-hmm. habits. So if you're lazy or if you're absent a lot, that's going to affect your work performance. So yes, it's critical that we understand our role and have a self-awareness about our abilities. And one of the things that you mentioned was about emotional intelligence. And I'm going to share just a little bit in terms of Mark, do you remember us talking about Maslow's hierarchy of needs?
Absolutely.
And so that is talking about human beings and our needs, okay? Mm-hmm. So at the very, it's a pyramid. At the very bottom of the pyramid, we have, we all have the need of food, clothing, and shelter and water. But as we climb our human needs pyramid, what we find right smack in the center is that we all have a need for belonging. Mm-hmm. And when we are in our workplaces, and that means being engaged, that means that we're having someone pay attention to us. So when we don't have those relationships mm-hmm. and we don't have that awareness, we can't build those relationships, and that can cause significant controversy in our workplaces, because sometimes what we find not just through the training, but also through the coaching, that a lot of situations are caused because of lack of information, lack of training. And that happens when we have a greater self-awareness about what our abilities are. Right. So emotional intelligence is critically important. It's one of the hot topics right now.
Absolutely.
Even though it's an old topic, it has become hot again, because emotional intelligence is about understanding your emotions and then how your emotions affect others, but also how your emotions are perceived by others. And that is helpful because you may think you're communicating one way or sharing information or training or coaching your employee one way, and they're observing it a whole different way. So the emotional intelligence course and having self-awareness really improves relationships that improve performance, that therefore lead to a bigger bottom line for organizations.
And isn't, at the end of the day, the bigger bottom line so important?
We are all in it to win it.
In it to win it. And I noticed one other thing you mentioned, and I know you're very passionate about this, coaching.
Yes.
How does that really play into the success of an organization?
Well, I start off with some explanation around, if you think about just raising a family. So now all of my children are adults. But when they were younger, I could say, go do this, go get that, don't do this, don't do that. Now that they are all adults, I had to even stop saying young adults because they're adults now. But now that they are all adults, I can't tell them what to do. Mm-hmm. I literally have to coach them into doing things that I think are beneficial for them. And, you know, if we think about just coaching in terms of sports, you know, every sports team has a coach. And the role of the coach is to help individuals reach their full potential. And I got inspired and excited about coaching when I learned Oprah Winfrey had a coach. And I was like, okay, if Oprah has a coach, then that must be a good thing. So it's not just for, you know, individuals who are struggling. Coaching is beneficial for anyone. And coaching helps in the workplace because the process enables individuals through a series of questions to really focus. They gain clarity. And in the workplace, isn't that what we need? We need clarity about our assignments, clarity about our objectives. We need to really understand the mission and goals of our organizations to be successful. And when individuals are successfully coached, the statistics are astounding, and that's why it's a passion of mine. They exceed goals. And the importance about, I keep talking about goals, but you have to have, even as an organization, you have to have training goals. We have performance goals. You should have training goals because that's going to help your performance. But the fact of the matter is that if we don't have support in reaching our goals, the statistics say that only 8% of people will reach them. That's not surprising. If you think about how many people set a New Year's resolution goal, and by the second week, they are back at the pizza shop. Right? So we all need coaching support, and coaching provides an accountability partner to say you can do it, and you outline your strategic plans and you execute, and you've got the support to keep going.
I love it. It's so vital to have that resource in a coach, and it's very interesting. I came to the same epiphany when I realized Tiger Woods had a coach.
Oh, okay.
So coaching is very important. And one other aspect that we wanted to touch upon today is, not only are we at the Chamber really focusing on the training of employees and supervisors, but also mid-level management, because we really want to really achieve that alignment of messaging, of vision, of strategy. So what we have at the Chamber are two training programs, Lessons in Leadership, which is a six-week program, full day, very interactive. Once again, a lot of peer-to-peer learning. And actually, that has been so successful that this fall, we're going to be rolling out our new Lessons in Leadership too.
Exciting.
It really is. So I think we're at a stage in where training is really being recognized for what it can bring. And when you realize that interpersonal skills training linked in with the technical training really produces an organization that is highly effective, that's what we're looking for.
Absolutely, absolutely. And the wonderful thing about enabling your managers, mid-level managers, to receive the training is, you know, messages are most effective coming down. Mm-hmm. So if you see behaviors in your management team, that will trickle down to the supervisors, to the lead workers, mm-hmm. and that enhances the organization's effectiveness.
Absolutely. So what I really want to stress is this fall, we're going to not only be delivering supervisor training, lead worker training, lessons in leadership for our mid-level management. We also have a new program, the Work of Leaders, which is also, when you said it comes down, is for executives. And this has been a very fascinating learning experience where we get leaders and we get them in a room for multiple weeks so they can really discuss and have that commonality of strategy and mm-hmm. vision and how they're going to achieve that. Right. So at the Chamber, we're trying to make sure that we're able to address all those concerns, because at the end of the day, a vibrant business community will help to have a vibrant community in total.
That peer group is going to be really important. I think about when I started my organization, you need a team. Mm-hmm. And so to have a team of other CEOs or other leaders that you can converse with and, as you said, share strategies and gain information, that's exciting. Mm-hmm. I'm looking forward to that.
Thank you. It really is. And one of the things that we're so proud at the Chamber is not only our curriculum, but the passion and the expertise that our instructors bring. And Adrean, you really encapsulate all that. So as hopefully you can tell from our discussion this afternoon, that you see the passion that we both have.
Yes.
In bringing training and helping to elevate the businesses, be them large or small. Because a lot of times in our training sessions, and I'm sure you've experienced this in supervisor training or lead worker training, we have individuals from very large manufacturers and sometimes from small family-owned businesses.
Yes.
So is there any other items that you wanted to talk about today, Adrean, as far as what you see during your training that has been really successful, or any passions that you see helping the business community in the future?
Well, what I will share is that employees perform at their best when they are valued, rewarded, recognized, feel empowered, and trusted. When you provide excellence in terms of training for your employees, those are the results that you're going to get. And so it not only gives them the skill sets that they need, but as an organization, you grow because they grow and you're investing in them. So what I see is people that are just very excited when they leave, not always mm-hmm. when they come, right. because they're not sure what to expect, but when they walk out the door, they're on board.
I love what you said, because training needs to be viewed as an investment. And I would like to end this by saying the cost is in not investing in your training. The investment is having highly skilled, highly engaged employees who are going to stay. You'll keep that institutional knowledge, and you'll have employees who are qualified to move up to the next level. And when employees realize that employers are really taking that time, that attention to really groom and help their employees succeed, we all succeed.
That's right, and they stay.
That's the most important thing, because one of the big costs is hiring. And by having your employer stay, not only will you retain your talent, but you'll retain your top talent. So that's, I'd like to say goodbye and thank you for letting us share the Greater Reading Chamber of Commerce and Industry's perspective on workforce development. Thank you.
Thank you.
Your Chamber on BCTV is supported by Herbine & Company, Incorporated.